During the Machuja Day celebrations in Kirinyaga County, His Excellency President Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta made various pronouncements with regard to the COVID-19 situation in the country. The head of state also gave a roadmap on the way forward as we continue to battle this pandemic here in our country. However, there have been a few issues that a section of Kenyans have raised, including you members of the press, that you wanted clarified. Whereas the president was clear in his speech, I shall try to clarify a few issues or a few details that have been raised across the country. First and foremost, as you are aware, the head of state, on advice by the National Emergency Response Committee on Coronavirus, vacated the dusk to dawn curfew that we have been having for the last 1 year. The curfew is one of the measures that was introduced with the aim of curtailing the spread of the virus. I'm sure that many of you will attest to the fact that it has helped a great deal in that regard. Secondly, there have been issues raised as to what happens with regard to the closure of bars at 7 p.m. that had equally been announced by His Excellency the President in his previous address. With the removal of the curfew next week, what happens? This is the way it is. With the removal, we are reverting to closure of bars and restaurants at 11 p.m. or the time allowed by the licensing authorities. Protocols on hand washing, social distancing, sanitizing, however, remain in force. This means that all facilities will still be expected to have hand washing posts and abide by the seating capacity as include not just what we have set forth as far as COVID-19 protocols are concerned, but as set forth even previously on health grounds. For example, the sanitary facilities in restaurants, in meat-eating facilities, in all areas that there is consumption of any sort of food must be met, including cleanliness of toilets and so on and so forth. This is a condition that must be met for bars to continue. And we have directed that where those are not met, then the situation must be addressed within the law and what the law says, including the closure of those institutions. On a different note, there's also been issues raised about night travel and with regard to public service vehicles. In the same way that the ministry has developed protocols in collaboration with the stakeholders in the hospitality sector, we have done the same with the transport sector. I am aware that the Ministry of Transport is seized of this matter, and we will be appraising you in the shortest possible time. Fellow Kenyans, we are continuing with our plans to accelerate our vaccination program to ensure that we can contain and sustain what the President announced yesterday, including the ability for us to continue with the curfew as it is. The opening, the cessation of use of the curfew is also dependent on how well we are able to move forward as far as vaccination is concerned and the health protocols. You are all aware that there are many countries that have done exactly the same, opened up and very quickly reverted back to the protocols that were there before as a result of the resumption of high levels of virus infections. This, we hope, is not going to happen to us, because we want to very quickly wrap up our vaccination rate and get as many people as possible. And I wish to state that the vaccination supply situation in the country, the vaccine supply situation, has now been greatly improved. In the next 2 weeks, we shall have received and supplied all doses required for us to receive our target of 10 million people by December. Later this evening, in fact, we shall be receiving an additional 500,000 Johnson & Johnson vaccines through the AVRT mechanism to bolster our efforts. We also hope to receive even more vaccines over the next few days and weeks through different mechanisms. With this improved supply, our focus now is getting the vaccines into as many arms as possible within the shortest time possible. Our appeal, therefore, is to all those who are eligible for vaccination to turn up at vaccination posts or at outreach venues. The reduced positivity rates does not mean that the pandemic is over and that there will be no other wave. Nothing is farther from the truth. It's very easy to have the situation get out of hand and rise in infections again. I therefore want to once again appeal to Kenyans not to relent and ensure that they get vaccinated. I appeal to younger people to ensure that their parents are vaccinated and to urge them to do so and to make arrangements for them to do so. This is the best way of ensuring that you are taking care of your parents at the moment. As you are aware, two of the vaccines that we are using, that is Pfizer and Moderna, once removed from the freezers, must be used within 30 days, which means that they have a short shelf life once they are put to use. As we have guided in the past, health workers must plan and work very closely with the teams conducting community mobilization to ensure that we do not have any vaccine wastages. We have worked very, very hard to ensure that those vaccines benefit Kenyans and our overall COVID-19 response. Counties with low uptake must be prepared to share those doses with those that have mobilized their communities. We want to ensure that that target by December of 10 million persons have been met. As His Excellency the President also announced yesterday, the government has formed the Kenya BioVax Limited, a company that is now mandated to establish the manufacture of human vaccines in the country, starting in the initial stages with a fill and finish plant for COVID-19 vaccines. I am also happy now to report that indeed a multi-agency technical team, which has been working on the project, has laid out a roadmap that will ensure the fill and finish plant is operational as was directed by His Excellency the President. I am also happy to report that the physical location for the project has been identified and you'll be in the go-downs of KEMSA at Embakasi. Finally, as infections rate remains low and we begin to reopen, let's ensure that we behave responsibly using the lessons that we have learned in our fight against the disease so far. We will not tire of reminding our people, our citizens, that social distancing remains important. I have literally noticed that people are beginning to stretch their hands to greet others. Don't take the stretched hand. Just tell him, Yatosha. Just tell him Yatosha, because that is the beginning of indiscipline. The idea of social distancing remains important for us. So please, even as we are culturally oriented towards handshakes and such other good behavior, as it were in the past, we have not reverted to physical contact of any kind, such as